Niner, can you hear me? Golf Echo Niner to dispatch.
Copy. Fucking blow ass up.
Golf Echo Niner to dispatch, reporting an explosion near the LZ. Multiple fires, got smoke and low visibility. Please advise. Roger that. Ascending to a safe altitude.
Oh damn.
NMS Tower, Golf Echo Niner climbing to 1800 feet. T's and P's are green, but fuel is limited. Final approach in 8 minutes. Repeat, 8 minutes.
Oh wow. Oh wow. I need a hideout fast. Last fight. But I don't think my flashlight. It should lure him. Yeah, okay. I wish I could like turn it off though. I mean, yeah, that is so cool though, this fluorescent shit. For some reason I don't have flashlight here. Now I have? What?
NMS Tower, Golf Echo Niner descending to 500 feet. Getting some crosswind, but smoke is clearing. 3 minutes to final approach. 3 minutes.
I vote for fast slide. Yeah. agile, aren't you? Can't connect. Oh, okay. Well, that's convenient. It's kind of weird, though, that you can just wait it out. Shit. Okay, run. Bye. Oh shit. Just fucking go. I think it happened in the movies as well. T-Rex just eating on the raptors. Well, there was an ally apparently. Where's the helicopter?
NMS Tower, Golf Echo Niner has arrived on Pad Bravo. Awaiting passengers. Departing in 2 minutes. Repeat, 2 minutes to departure.
Give me this. Ay, ay. Hell yeah! What? The 360 environment is a comic as well. Do we actually like just bring them the blue DNA though?
Dispatch, vital cargo is secured, ready to depart.
Well, off we go.
T's and P's are green, skies are clear. Ascending to 1800 and departing out the northwest route. Hey, back there. Look, I'm sorry about your friend. Whatever you found, I hope it was worth it.
Oh right, the photo.
It was right then I knew I wanted to be a genetic engineer. Knowing that a life, even an unremarkable one, can leave an impression. Inspire hope. This was always a rescue. She's finally coming home. We don't have the luxury of knowing where our decisions will lead. But do me a favor. Destroy that sample. Send it to the bottom of the North Pacific. Don't let them have it. Don't make it easy.
Can I jump with it? Last wish granted.
And live. For that girl in Montana. Make a difference.
Hmm.
That was the game.
After almost 1 year, we managed to finish it. Honestly, I enjoyed myself way more in the part 2 than the first one, simply because of just the gameplay mechanics. It was too stale for too long that it almost seemed like a Raptor Simulator. Here, we had T-Rex gameplay, more variety in puzzles. Still, I think there was a room to improve on certain aspects. Maybe introduce like a new AI for Raptors. Like I mentioned before, it was way too easy to predict their movement, and I didn't feel like this time around there was like a noticeable change. Something was added, of course, but not to the point that I was struggling to survive. Overall, I enjoyed myself. It's like a first real entry to my horror experiences, which it's very light. It's just few jump scares here and there. The tension of being around Raptors and getting eaten alive. There are some scary parts, but like very minor. But yeah, I'm pretty sure we're done with this. There's like nothing else to discover aside from maybe some extras like collectibles or whatever. I'm not even sure if this game has, but I don't really care. I do play through in terms of storyline, so it's a wrap up on this title.